genome, your DNA is like an instruction manual. It's the directions of how to make you.
There's 20,000 genes in the genome, and we know roughly the function of a quarter of those genes.
Each one of our cells has a copy of our DNA. Those are 3 billion base pairs, so it's an incredible amount of data in each given cell. And we've got millions and millions of cells in our body. Each one of those cells has to be able to function appropriately.
Any mistake in the sequence can lead to what's called a mutation, which then can lead to severe disease.
The instructions for each one of those individual cells is present in that overall booklet. And each cell has to understand, oh, this is the chapter that I need to read, and everything in that chapter better be correct.
We've always known that the genes in our genome can make us sick. The challenge has been that in the past, even though we knew that the genome was making you sick, what we didn't know is how could we identify the sequence change that made you sick. We are able to now sequence your genome and identify a particular sequence change that might be making you sick. The use of that sequence to treat patients, to change their care, to diagnose why they're sick, that's genomic medicine.
It's not simply studying an idea or a concept, but it's bringing it back to an individual human being and saying, how does your genome affect who you are?
My son Zeke, when he was born, he was very sick. The doctors thought it was some type of infection, but they really couldn't figure out what the cause was.
Generally, what we do in those situations is provide fluids, antibiotics, and the babies get better. But this baby didn't get better. In fact, seemed to be getting worse.
He just went downhill fast, and they tried their best, but they just couldn't save him, and so he ended up dying. 2 weeks after Zeke passed away, I got sick as well and had to go to the ER with a severe cough and fever.
One of the things that's very important about the genome is that these instructions are passed from parents to child.
They started to talk about a genetic component.
At that time, we decided to go ahead and do genome sequencing, and we identified that the dad of this baby had a mutation in a gene called NLRC4.
DNA sequencing is like a spell check. When we do sequencing, we look at that instruction manual, and we look at each letter in the instruction manual. We look at each word that's formed from the letters.
If you want to take care of anyone who's ill, you need to understand the disease process. And knowing this mutation really transformed the way we were thinking about this disease.
I had this new mutation that they had never heard of. It explained so many different types of symptoms that I'd had since childhood.
And what's important is it's not just the baby that had this mutation. Dad also had the mutation. Because we understood the process better, we could deliver care that was much more effective, specifically for Erik and his family.
Caring for Erik's son was an incredibly important moment for his family. And in many ways, this was what launched our program.
It was just amazing for me to think that what happened to him helped so many other families with genetic mutations. Previously, their illnesses were unexplained, and then all of a sudden there's an answer. It's because of what happened to Zeke.
In the Pediatric Genomics Discovery Program, what we do is we'll identify a child that we believe has a genetic disease.
Our daughter was totally healthy until the day she wasn't. Same for our son. The day actually that our son had passed away, one of our doctors approached us and he said, I'd really like to send off your genetics to Yale.
The program is designed to help give a diagnosis to children who have rare, unusual diseases.
It's really important to the families to have an idea of what the disease process was. Maybe another family won't have to go through the same pain that we've been through.
We isolate DNA. That DNA is then sent to Yale Center for Genome Analysis, where they put it on the sequencing machine and sequence it. But we immediately take any results from that gene sequencing and bring it to the laboratory to understand the disease process, because that knowledge may transform the way we care for the patient.
The way that it's been able to affect our family in a positive light and for us to be able to move forward with our family is just amazing.
She said, you have one mutation. I was like, what does that mean? She explained it to me like, I would be okay. It's kind of one of those moments where you want to just jump up, scream, and laugh, and cry all at the same time.
So it's absolutely amazing. We can have precision therapies that are guided by what we find from our DNA sequencing. I think in many ways, genomics is synonymous with personalized medicine.
We have to deliver a care that's unique to each of us. If we understood how our genes cause us to be ill, we could tailor our therapy just for the particular disease process that that patient has. That is fundamentally the goal of genomic medicine.
By studying and understanding what our genes do, we get a better picture of how the human body functions. And that picture, I believe, is going to be impactful for all of us in the future.